heavyweight boxing fans, what's the deal? So, I've been hearing a lot of fans think that Anthony Joshua will probably fight Dillian White next. That's what I'm hearing from a lot of fans. Just going to give my quick prediction on that fight. If this fight does happen to come to fruition, I think AJ splatters him within a few rounds. From what I see from Dillian White, I've seen his last fight. Who did he just fight, man? Ivica Bakurin? I believe that's who he just fought. I was looking at White's weight for that fight. He didn't come in the fight in shape. He looked very sloppy. His technique was off. He was winging just wild shots. He looked the same as he did in the Joshua fight as far as the way his technique and his form looked. Now, some of you may say he just came off an injury. Just give him a break. Okay, cool. I understand that. And I'm a big guy myself. I'm 6'5", 240. So I'm a big guy myself. But at the same time, though, whether you're coming off an injury or not, that doesn't mean coming to the fight out of shape. Like, I don't get some of these boxers, man. They want to use the excuse of, I'm coming off an injury. Okay, well, sit your injured ass down and get in the proper shape and then get into a fight. You don't come into a fight just at your career high. He was at his career high. He was at 253. Now, granted, it was 1 pound higher than his previous career high. His first professional fight was 252. And then the very next fight, I think, came in like 230. So I'm not ready to, cross him out of the, runnings as far as, a good heavyweight because he came in at 253. I mean, the guy is 6'4". But it's just, to me, you came into this fight just out of shape, man. And just from what I see, I just don't think he's going to be good enough to beat Anthony Joshua. I think what he did in that first fight was his best effort. I think he gave it all he got. And I think that's that. You know what I mean? He landed a good shot. He couldn't do nothing with Joshua. And it was just one shot. I mean, everybody's like ranting and raving over this one punch that he landed. It was one punch. It wasn't like it was, in 3 of the 7 rounds, he was really, getting busy on Anthony and, it was landing a plethora of shots. It's just one left hook that he landed. And granted, now it did hurt him. It did buzz him and stun him, but he couldn't do anything. And according to Dillian White, it was when he hurt Joshua, was when he threw out his shoulder. Ironically, it happened all at the same time. So, okay, fine. I'll give him that. But I don't know, man, just coming in at your career high, being very, he just looked out of shape to me, man. And just his technique looked sloppy. And I think AJ has gotten better since their first fight. And I think AJ's jab is looking a little bit better. I think his punches going down the middle is looking a little bit better. Now, anything could happen. Dillian White can go in there and knock him out. Anything can happen. I'm not, like I said, I'm not totally just dismissive of Dillian White, but I just don't see him beating Anthony Joshua. If they do fight next, hey, I guess they fight next. But I wouldn't want to see him fight Dillian White. I want to see him fight the guys who he's been naming. If anything, Dillian White needs to fight some other guys in the mix, man. Fight some of those Americans who we think are complete bums. And okay, well, I like to see you beat those guys. I know Chisora was a fight. David Allen was another fight. But just talking alone, Jarrell Miller, I like to see him fight Jarrell Miller or Trevor Bryan or some of these other undefeated up and coming type of prospects, even a Michiel Wallace or Tom Schwartz, Adrian Grenade. I like to see him fight some of those guys. Maybe he could beat them. Maybe he can't beat them. But I'm not ready just to anoint Dillian White as this top 10 type of heavyweight because he landed one good shot on Anthony Joshua. Come on, man. That doesn't really make any sense. Carlos Takam, all these guys who he said he could have beat or he could have iced or who he's not impressed with, I want to see him get thrown in there with some of those guys. I like Dillian White, but I want to see some of this stuff now. You know what I mean? Yes, you landed the good shot on AJ, but Corin, you got him out of there. But you want to see you tighten up on some things, man. And your gut area is something I think you should tighten up on. You can't be this young. You know, I got some years on these guys, man. I'm 36. So you can't be that young in your mid, late 20s, man, with a gut on you. You know what I mean? And there's a lot of fighters walking around with guts on them. And I've got on all of them. You know, Charles Martin, Brazil. There's a few guys. Even Jarrell Miller is a guy who I like to see him get down a little bit in his weight. You know what I mean? So I'm not just picking on Dillian White here. But if it is AJ versus White, I think AJ gets him out of there even quicker this time. I think something down the middle is going to get him out of there while Dillian White is throwing wide winging hooks. I just want to see his technique sharpen up a little bit. I think White has a future, man. I just want to see that technique sharpen up and get that cardio up, man. I'm just because you coming off an injury doesn't give you a leeway to come into a fight out of shape. That doesn't make any sense to me. And for those of you that's been in gyms, has worked out, been athletes, played, you know, American college football or basketball like myself, you know that when you're trying to perform or you're trying to work out, the best way for you to re-injure yourself is being out of shape, is being overweight or coming in at your career highs and all that shit. So surprising he didn't re-injure himself in the Bakurin fight. Just my two cents on it. I know some of you Dillian hardcore Dillian White fans going to disagree with me. It's all good, though. I'm out.